What's up, guys? Salvadorian boy here. We are on our way to Brownsville on a job that we're doing. So I am just recording with my buddy Josh. And it's the end of the year, and I wanted to see, or I wanted to think back on what this whole COVID was for me personally. So yeah, I'll take you along for that, and let's go to Brownsville. Buddy Josh.
Hello, hello.
You've never been in one of my videos, huh?
Never.
So, I really just, out of nowhere, wanted to do a video of how different 2020 was. And, you know, every year is different. Every year in December, you look back on what you did the whole year, whether you accomplished what you said you were going to do, whether you didn't, and you want to do it again next year, see if you can do it. But I really don't have a script on what I'm gonna do, or actually what challenges I had, or what was the most memorable. I know one for sure, but let's see where this video takes us, and I'll just open up to you guys. So, it is currently the next day. We made it to Brownsville pretty late last night, so we decided to sleep in the van. That's a really cool background. So, I'll start with the first thing. The first thing that I decided to do in 2020 was quit my job. All right, so, is April 14, 2020. I am doing this to better myself and my family. The office job really wasn't working out, so hopefully this really works. I was working in customer service, and I was really getting tired of it. And you know, last year in 2019, we found out that we were having our second child. So it's official doctor visit number 2, which was a huge blessing, because with little Salvi, we were having infertility issues, and it was very hard on the relationship and the marriage. And it was just hard on us, and finding out that we were having our second child was a complete like woe feeling and woe factor. So I knew that we were gonna need more income, and customer service wasn't gonna give me what we needed. So I decided to quit my job and go back to what I was doing back in high school, which was construction. The only bad thing about that is that we have to travel. You know, we're in Brownsville, so I'd rather be home with a family. And unfortunately, because the income, I have to travel out. So that's the first decision I made in 2020. So yeah, I'll keep telling y'all the story. Stay tuned. So the next part of the story was when I bought the OB. God, it's freezing cold. Let's go get some coffee. Alright, so let's go get this coffee.
Hey, mask. COVID ain't no joke, bro.
He's right. Gotta go get that mask. Hey, how you doing? All right, so this gas station where we came, they didn't allow any refills with our cups, so we had to get theirs, which is understandable. So next part of the story. Well, first, cheers.
Cheers.
The next part of the story is when I got my OBS. So where I was working at a shop, and this guy came in, and it's this old truck that he had. It was a 95 Chevy truck, and he was trying to fix it, but the fix was too expensive for him, and he wanted to sell the truck. Originally, I believe he wanted like $2,500 for the truck, and he left. I got his number, and I called him back, and I was like, "Hey, I don't have $2,500. I mean, I understand, but the most I can give you for the truck is $1,000." And he's like, "Come pick it up." So yeah, it was a really nice truck. I couldn't keep it because my wife was like, it's too many cars that you have. You have the Jeep, you have the bike, you have this van in the driveway, and now you're gonna have a truck? What are you gonna do with the truck? And I was like, well, I was planning on building it. And she was like, we're having another child. Where are you gonna get the money to build this truck? I ended up selling the truck, and I bought it for $1,000, and I fixed up the inside, which was in really good shape. There was a few things that were broken, but I fixed those things. The issue was that when you started the truck, it wouldn't stay on. So my father-in-law said that it would, you know, it was a fuel tank, so we replaced that. And it was fun. It was running really, really good. So I finally sold it on OfferUp for $4,000.
Not bad.
Not a bad turn on my $1,000 investment. Yeah. I really didn't want to sell it though. But yeah, next part of the story. So we've made it back home. Little quick turnaround on that job that we did. But yeah, the next part of the story is we actually decided to jump in and buy a house in 2020. Full-blown COVID. Here's our Christmas tree and a little bit of decorations. But yeah, we decided to buy a house. I threw out the idea because of our family was growing. I said, why don't we try buying a house? Market's low and everything, so that's what you want to do, right? Buy low, sell high. So everything was working out in our favor. So it worked out. We had some good memories in our old house. You know, we've made it our own. We set up little Salvi's room. There was just a lot of memories, and we got this house. It's a little bit bigger. We got a bigger backyard, and just something that we can grow into is kind of what we were trying to do. But right away, we made some changes to the house. We didn't like the flooring. We changed the flooring. And we also upgraded our dining room, dining tables. But yeah, we really like the move here. And it feels a lot more homier and a lot more room for two growing kids. So, yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you guys for letting me open up to you guys, and thank you for sticking around this long. If you made it to the end, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing and hit that notification bell so you can know every time that I upload. And yeah, don't forget, you guys are awesome. Oh, and Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. See you guys later.